Hi everyone, welcome back. So in this video we'll be covering operators in Python. So I've already opened a Python shell, so in case you have not opened, you can open Python shell and we'll be trying out the operators in this interactive mode. Here you can see the three greater than sign. These are called primary prompts. Okay, so let's start. So the first operator which I'm going to cover is the plus operator. Okay, so if we type 2 plus 3 here, 2 plus 3, it should give us 5. So you can see the result. So if I type 12.3 plus 3.4, the result should be, so it gives a float value. Okay, similarly we can say 12 minus 4, so 8. Okay, so for subtraction we have minus, just like in other languages, 12 into 4. For multiplication we have this asterisk symbol. Okay, and it gives us this. And for division in Python, let's suppose I say 22 divided by 7. So when I do this, a division in Python will always return a float value. Okay, so see, we get this float value. If you want to discard the decimal part, in that case we have to do something called floor division. Now what is this floor division in Python? So instead of using this divide sign which we have used, what we'll do for floor division, we'll use this double sign, okay, double division sign by 7. Okay, so now you see we get only the integer part. So if you use single slash, it gives you a float division. Okay, let's say again 22 divided by 7, it gives me 3.14, but when I do 22 double slash 7, it gives me a integer division. Okay, so this kind of division is called floor division in Python. Now if you want the remainder of the division, so let's say 22 mod 7. So what it will do is, it will divide 22 by 7 and give you the remainder. So in case you want the remainder, you have to use the percentage sign. So let's see. So it divides 22 by 7. 7 threes are 21 and the remainder is 1. So we are getting the output as 1. So if we want the remainder, then we should use this modulus sign. This is known as modulus. Modulus, okay. Right, so now let's try some other operators. Let's suppose here, okay, let's try an expression here. Let's suppose we write 5 into 3 plus 2. Okay, so what should be the result? It will give 5 into 3, 15 plus 2. Okay, 17. Now, what if we want a number raised to the power? Let's suppose we want 2 raised to the power 3. So, what operator do we have here? So, in Python, there is a special operator, that is, we have this double multiplication sign, double asterisk and 3. Okay, so this means 2 raised to the power 3. So, this should give you 2 into 2 into 2, that is 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8. So, this is the symbol which we can use if we want to find the power of a number. So, this evaluates to 2 raised to the power 3. Now let's write an expression which has mixed operands. That means if one of the operand is, like here we had an expression, but all the operands, you understand, operands means the values on which the operators act. So all the three operands here, in this case 5, 3 and 2, were all integer. Okay, now let's create an expression, maybe 2 into, let's say, 5.6. So when you write 2 into 5.6, one operand is integer and one is float. 5.6 is float and 2 is integer. So when you write such an expression, the entire value is promoted to a float or converted to a float value. So you can see we get 11.2. Okay, now another interesting thing which I want to show you is, let's say I say a is equal to 10 and b is equal to, let's say, 20. Okay, now if we write a plus b, it prints the result a plus b, that is 20 plus 10, 30. Okay, now I want to show you one thing here. When we write b plus underscore, okay, I'm writing b plus underscore. What is the last value of b? B is 20 plus underscore. So it is giving me 50. So why is it giving me 50? This underscore, it stores the last printed value, or the last printed value. Okay, what is the last printed value? It is 30 here. So b plus underscore means b is 20. 20 plus underscore means it is 30. So this gives us 50. Okay. Let's try another function. We have a round function here, okay, r-o-u-n-d. Okay, when we say round 17.2, it will round it up. Sorry, okay, let's write it again. That was a mistake here. So round, we have to write 17.2. okay, so it is rounded down. When I write round 17.6, so okay, round 17.6, so it is promoted up, it's rounded up. Okay, so we can see that if it is greater than 0.5, then it is rounded up. If it is less than 0.5, it is rounded down. And what if it is exactly 0.5? In that case, let's say 17.5. What happens? In that case, again, it is rounded up. Okay, and that means 17.5 became 18. And if I write 12.5, so here, sorry, we have to write round 12.5. okay, so 12.5 is rounded down, but 17.5 is rounded up. So why so? Because if you see, notice here 17 is an odd number and here 12 is an even number. So if it is an odd number, so if we have, in case of odd numbers with 0.5, it is rounded up. In case of even numbers with 0.5, it is rounded down. Okay, so that's the thing which I wanted to note. And another thing which I want to show you is, okay, let's see, we write 2 into 5.6. okay, so as I told you earlier, this will, the entire expression becomes a float value. Now what if I want to round off this value? Okay, so we'll say round, and I said underscore, as I told earlier also, underscore will store the it stores the last printed expression. So in this case, the last value was 11.2, so round will round off 11.2. okay, so when we press enter, so see 11.2 is rounded down to 11. Okay, so this is how the operators, some of the operators work in Python. There are more operators which I'll be covering in the next video, but as of now, I think this is about it. And if you like the video, please don't forget to click on the like button and don't forget to click on the bell icon. Thanks for watching.